Thank you. It's certainly a pleasure to have the opportunity to keynote the World Blockchain Summit, especially here, because today, in the world of blockchain, all roads lead to Dubai, clearly the emerging blockchain capital of the world. And as we saw in Wessam Luta's very impressive presentation, not only is Dubai already a city of the future, but it is accelerating even faster into the future. In our first scene, a preteen needs orthodontic work. But she and her parents don't just go to the nearest orthodontist or one a friend or relative recommends. Instead, they post an online request for proposals that can only be seen by nearby registered orthodontists and receive several such proposals, each of which states the qualifications of the orthodontist and a recommended treatment plan. After speaking to a couple of the orthodontists by phone, they select one to meet with in person. Once they've reviewed the treatment plan and payment schedule with the orthodontist, they authorize it electronically via digital signatures on their flexible smartphones. The family's health care insurance makes progress payments directly deposited into the orthodontist's account immediately upon completion of each visit. The family makes their co-payments using airline frequent flyer miles, and at no point is any paperwork required in the entire process. In our second scene, an aircraft is halfway across the ocean when it detects that a critical part must be replaced on arrival. The airline's advanced procurement system scans the internet to identify Civil Aviation Authority approved providers of that required part. The system then negotiates pricing, terms, and conditions, selects a provider, and incorporates those terms into a legally enforceable online smart contract, on completion of which the part's design is then downloaded to a 3D printer at the airport, and the part is waiting at the gate when the aircraft arrives. And many have already recognized that this technology is the most significant to emerge since the internet itself. This technology doesn't just enable improvements in specific areas, it facilitates the digital transformation of entire business and social ecosystems. Healthcare, transportation, manufacturing, financial services, real estate are just a few of the many potential applications of this technology across every industry, including yours. And while this technology has been around for nearly a decade now, most people around the world, most executive decision makers, have only really started to hear about it in the past year or two. It's called blockchain technology. And no less prestigious a publication than The Economist magazine has stated that blockchain is quite simply the most important advance in record keeping since the invention of the double entry bookkeeping system in Florence, Italy in 1494, over 500 years ago. Blockchain technologies do four key things that we've not been able to do nearly so well and together previously. First, they provide a permanent, immutable, signed and time-stamped record of identity, ownership, transactions, or commitments. Secondly, that record can then be shared among two or more entities, people, businesses, other organizations, what have you, without any one of the entities in that ecosystem having to depend on any one of the others or having to pay a third-party intermediary to facilitate the sharing of that information. Third, the information can be made globally available to all of the authorized participants with complete transparency for everyone authorized to see it and the authority to update that information for that subset of those who are authorized to do so. At the same time, it provides unhackable security against those unauthorized to update that information or even see it. Now, as soon as I use the word unhackable, lots of people say, well, given enough time and resources, any computer can be hacked. And that's why blockchain data is not stored on any computer. It's stored on many computers. Depending on the implementation of blockchain, identical copies of the blockchain data are stored on anywhere from dozens to hundreds to thousands of computers all over the internet. Every time a new record is added to the blockchain, that information is synchronized to all of those computers within minutes, if not seconds, depending again on the nature of the implementation. The world's most advanced cryptographic and synchronization technologies are used to ensure that all of those copies of the blockchain remain identical to every other copy. Well, when people realized what this meant and that this could be used for digital currencies, they began to also realize it could be used for a lot of other things, such as electronic medical records, 3D printing design files, or real estate land titles. One more key thing that can be put on the blockchain are smart contracts. Now, this is more than just a digital version of a traditional contract created on a word processing system. Smart contracts are dynamic contracts that can be self-enforcing. It's a computer program running on a blockchain that can take custody over assets on that blockchain, track what has happened to date, and respond to incoming information or events, such as the airline has completed the execution of a smart contract and is therefore authorized to download the design file for a part. Or the orthodontist visit has been successfully completed and therefore the orthodontist is to be transferred the appropriate payment for the services rendered at that particular time without any human intervention being required in the process. It's already producing extraordinary results. I had the privilege not quite a year ago to speak at the Global Big Data Forum in Qingdao, a major port on the northeast coast of China. By an extraordinary coincidence, on the weekend before my presentation, a ship arrived in the port of Qingdao carrying a load of cotton being sold from a company in Houston, Texas to a company in China. Now, in international trade today, typically processing the paperwork and information necessary to transfer ownership in that kind of situation from seller to buyer and get the seller paid and also to pay the freight carrier for their transportation services takes about 10 days. In this particular case, because all of the relevant information was stored on the blockchain, as soon as they were able to scan the barcodes on the pallets containing that cotton and verify that they had arrived, they were able to complete the entire process and pay both the seller and the transportation carrier in 10 minutes. Think about the implications of that from a working capital management perspective in international trade. In the area of healthcare, with patient-mediated health data exchange, we'll be able to provide accountability, transparency, privacy, security, control, and provenance, who had the authority to and did update information about a particular patient, all under the control of patient consent management, so that we won't have to be going in and filling out the same forms every time we see a doctor or waiting days or weeks for information be transferred from one doctor or clinic or healthcare organization to another. But again, these are just a few of the industries. Here is a very partial list of a couple of dozen industries that will be very significantly impacted by blockchain. And if your industry is not on this list, it's only because I ran out of space, not because it's not going to be impacted by blockchain. And many of these industries already have industry consortia in place, actively developing strategic plans for using blockchain to reshape how these industries work. These consortia have come up with hundreds of use cases, just a tiny fraction of which are shown on this slide. So, lots of interesting things going on with blockchain. Exciting things even. And yet, none of this matters unless you have a strategy for your business, for your organization, for blockchain transformation. Blockchain plays a critical role in digital transformation. Most emerging technologies, AI, 3D printing, augmented reality, Internet of Things, are point solutions. And that, by that I mean they apply at specific business processes within a given organization, or even at a specific geographical location. Blockchain is different. Blockchain provides the decentralized infrastructural glue that ties all of those points together. And what that means is that it enables the digital transformation of not just individual processes or organizations, but entire businesses, indeed, entire governmental, business, or social ecosystems. We can rethink the way everything works together. But even blockchain transformation is not about force-fitting these new technologies, even one as powerful as blockchain, into your existing business processes and infrastructure. You start by understanding that blockchain is a team sport. The benefits come when you coordinate with the others in your ecosystem or ecosystems to work together to use blockchain to take cost, errors, delays, time, out of your overall processes, rethinking your business, governmental, or social ecosystems. Then you, as an individual company, NGO, healthcare provider, governmental agency, what have you, need to rethink what your business model is. How do you add value today, and how will that change in the blockchain-enabled ecosystem of the world, of the future, and how will you need to change your business processes and indeed your business model to take full advantage of how you can add the most value for your organization, and then use any and all technologies, blockchain and others, to implement that new vision. Now, when we work with clients to help them develop their blockchain transformation strategy, we recommend planning and executing the strategy with three parallel components. One, having a long-term vision of how the blockchain-enabled digital ecosystem will work, and a long-term vision of the blockchain-enabled digital enterprise, business, governmental agency, what have you. Secondly, looking at your existing business processes and determining how they're going to evolve. Some of them will go away entirely. And so you don't need to invest a lot of time and money into enhancing those. Many will still be around, even if in radically digitally transformed ways, and consequently, that's how you're going to want to think about how those are going to change to move toward your third horizon vision. And then the second horizon is doing the testing, the proofs of concept, working with a new technology, whether it's blockchain, Internet of Things, AI, or what have you, and working with new business processes with the idea of evolving those second horizon near-term proofs of concept into live production as you evolve those parts of your current operations, first horizon planning, so that they merge together as you move out 2 to 3 to 5 years into your vision of the future. This is exactly what I believe, based on what I saw and heard today, is what the government of Dubai is doing as a part of their Dubai 2020 initiative to become the first government on the blockchain. It is certainly something that they need to incorporate into their planning process and that you need to incorporate into your business or organization's planning process. But if they're going to be successful, and if you are going to be successful, you've got to overcome the most significant hurdles to blockchain adoption. And in a study done just recently by Cognizant, they identified the top hurdles to blockchain adoption. And what you will see are they include such things as understanding blockchain and use cases, communicating blockchain to key decision makers, senior level executives, estimating cost benefits of use cases and so forth. They almost none of these have to do with technological implementation. They have to do with awareness and understanding on the part of senior executive decision makers as to the strategic implications of blockchain technology. People like Wassam Luta have that awareness, but it needs to be spread across government and across business in every organization. At the American Blockchain Council, that's our objective, and we've developed a series of recommendations that the key people who need to understand the strategic implications of blockchain technology include C-level executives and other senior executive business decision makers, such as accountants, auditors, attorneys, and senior IT management. Senior IT management understanding the business side of blockchain in addition to the IT technical side of blockchain. What do they need to know? Well, the key things that we recommend that they learn about are: what is blockchain technology? How does it work? Identity, security, smart contracts. Very importantly, how is this going to impact our industry? What opportunities are presented for our business? How do we develop our overall strategy for blockchain-enabled digital transformation? So if there are any of you that would like to get a copy of our recommendations on executive education for blockchain, please see me after the presentation or follow up with me via the contact information on the last slide. Now, I predict that the Dubai government will be successful in achieving becoming the first government on the blockchain. Does that mean every single last transaction that they do will be on the blockchain by 2020? Probably not, but I think they will have the vast majority of the major mission critical applications in place within the next 3 years, because they recognize the need for managing change. And that's a real key here. Because if you think things have changed a lot in the past 10 years since the first smartphones were introduced, you ain't seen nothing yet. Driven by a host of emerging technologies, perhaps most importantly blockchain, we will see more change in our businesses, in our society, in our lives, in the next 10 years than we've seen in the past 50 years. How are you going to address that change? It starts by changing your own mindset. You've got to think differently and be open to and actively soliciting of opportunities for change and improvement. But you've also got to change your corporate culture, your organizational culture. Your organization has to be looking for opportunities to change for the better. You have to change your business processes. You have to change your business model. You have to change your business ecosystem. That's a lot of change. But as the great historian Henry Steele Commager put it so well over a century ago, while change does not necessarily assure progress, progress implacably requires change. Join us in using blockchain technology as an enabler to change your organization, to change your industry, and to change the world. Thank you for listening.
Thank you.